Hi, welcome back. Okay, so now we need some invaders to shoot at and create a new sprite object. Name it invader. And this time we'll play animations. We have 2 frames for each invader, 3 in total. Rename the animation, set the animation speed to 2 per second, and loop option to yes. Then duplicate it 2 times. And replace the sprites with different ones. Be sure to check the collision polygon, use the function guess polygon shape, and apply it to the whole animation, in the 3 of them. Also check for the origin point in the middle. We'll set grid visible and activate Snap2. Then set the grid size to 16 by 16. This would make positioning the invaders easier. Control drag to copy them. Just 7 this time. You can just make them smaller, or make the screen bigger if you want more enemies. You can select and copy them, and select again and change the initial animation for each row. Now in the event sheet, create a every 1 second set invader X to the current X position plus 20. And now all our invaders are just leaving the screen. To fix that, create a new object. Name it wall. And give it a solid color. Place them by the sides of the screen. And set them to the back. Now select an invader and add an instance variable. Name it goRight. Set it as a boolean. And initial value to false. Go to the event sheet. On the start of layout, set goRight to false. Create two sub-events under the everyone second event and check. If invader goRight is true, then move the action here. And if invader goRight is false, control drag to copy the action and set it to minus 20. Create an event, invader is overlapping another object, select the wall, then system, trigger only once, so the event will be triggered by only one invader and not by the three of them that can be overlapping the wall, and system, pick all invaders, so the action will affect all the invaders on the screen, invaders, toggle boolean go right, now simply add invader set y to current y plus 16. The invaders can shoot at you too, so create a new object, invader bullet, give it the destroy outside layout behavior and bullet behavior. Then destroy it on the start of layout 2. Now every, let's say, 2 seconds, system, pick random instance of invader, invader, spawn another object, invader bullet. And set angle of motion to 90 degrees. You can now adjust the origin point so the bullet doesn't spawn in front of the invaders. You can apply your changes to all animations with just one click. Rearrange the invaders in the grid, and that's all. Okay, so far we have the player and the enemies. In the next video, we'll make them interact with each other and keep track of lives and score.